And I saw this vivid image, very strange sound that was moving through the Vatican. And then I saw darkness rising up over the Vatican. And then like that, I was awake. As soon as I woke up, I started to write down what I had saw. But instead, what I wrote down is Pope Benedict XVI is going to resign. And I even had the date and the year. It's going to happen in April.
Were you thinking about this? Are you a specialist in Catholicism? Was it anything on your radar?
No. I mean, we were doing some research at the time into the ancient prophecy of the popes, but there was nothing about Pope Benedict resigning. So we went through 2012, and I was on your program, all this other media, and I'm saying this is going to happen. He's going to retire in April of 2012.
And by the way, how often does a pope retire?
Well, it had not happened in over 600 years, and everybody, especially my Catholic friends, were emailing me, and they were saying, Tom, you're going to ruin your ministry. Popes don't retire. They die in office. You need to stop saying this.
So the date came and went, and it didn't happen. But what did you find out later?
Yeah, so the date came and went, and February of 2013, the Vatican makes this major global announcement. Pope Benedict XVI has retired from office. Now, that same day, the Vatican's media outlet, the El Observatore Romano, they gave an interview to the New York Times. People can Google this and read it for themselves. El Observatore Romano published an article. They also published one in the New York Times in which they made a revelation. They said Pope Benedict had actually secretly resigned when he returned from a trip in March. He resigned in March. It was accepted by the Curia in April of 2012, and we had gave both those times, not even knowing for sure what that even meant, right? And this had been, this was, you know, the Vatican invented for your eyes only CIA-level top secret security stuff, right? Nobody anywhere could know anything about this.